Hey guys, Nate Harris here with Stone River Outfitters. Thanks for joining me. In today's tutorial, I'm going to share with you how to tie a simplified black over orange fast food version of a high floating all foam favorite, the exceptionally deadly Chernobyl ant. An especially wise choice in the summertime when larger landborne terrestrials like grasshoppers, carpenter ants, beetles, crickets, and more are frequently found helplessly floundering in the currents, and surprisingly effective too when larger aquatic-borne insects such as salmon flies, stones, and October caddis are seen drifting idly on a stream surface as well. Let's go ahead and give tying the Chernobyl ant a try. To begin, we'll first start by taking a moment to pre-cut our large, flat, 2mm sheets of fly foam into long, thin, tying-friendly strips using a straight-edge ruler, a nice sharp razor blade, a chopping block, a steady hand, and of course a square careful aim. While the width of our strips may vary depending upon the hook size we choose to tie on, I generally find strips cut between 3/16 to a quarter of an inch max usually work best. With a nice healthy pile of pre-cut strips now built and set conveniently off to our side, we'll now begin tying the Chernobyl ant by starting our thread onto the hook via a tight wound jam knot placed just behind our hook eye, like shown. Naturally, once secured, we'll go ahead and rid ourselves of the excess with a quick firm tug. Next, we'll begin wrapping rearwards in smooth, continuous, close-wound fashion, a nice, neat, level-laid thread base, built carefully along the hook shank's entirety, continuing until we've at last reached a comfortable stop located about halfway between the hook's raised barb and the sharpened point. Next, to prepare our body, we'll go ahead and grab in hand a pre-cut strip of black and orange fly foam, and with the tips roughly evened and the strips positioned black over the orange, we'll then take a moment to trim the strip's ends at a 45 degree angle, both near side and far, with a quick couple of snips from our scissors. With the butt end of our body now cleanly cut, and a fair amount of it left protruding rearward beyond the hook bend, we'll next go ahead and mount the foam strips neatly at the fly's rear, directly above our hook barb, using a few well-placed, tight-drawn thread wraps made immediately atop one another. Next, with our butt snugly bound and neatly centered, we'll then go ahead and take in hand our medium round rubber legs, separating from the ribbon a 2 or 3 inch long pair. And once separated, we'll next tie them in, one at a time, first on the near side and then on the far, by conveniently pinching each rubber leg individually and evenly around our tying thread, then guiding the pinched leg accurately into position with our bobbin, locking each leg in place along the body's center line between the black and orange foam strips, like shown. Next, to create our ant's segmented underbody, we'll go ahead and lift, together, towards the rear, both the black and orange foam strips. And with both held back by our offhand, we'll then advance our thread quickly forward along our hook shank to a stopping point located about 1/3 the distance to our hook eye. Once there, we'll simply loosen our grasp over the orange underbody strip. And with the orange foam pressed neatly flat along the hook shank's top, we'll go ahead and lash the first segment securely with a couple of well-placed snug-wound thread wraps. To create our second segment, we'll simply repeat, sweeping both strips rearward before advancing our thread along the hook shank about the same distance as wound before, where we'll again release and then bind down only the orange strip using a few more notably tight-wound turns of thread. For our third and final body segment, we'll again pull both strips to the rear, advancing our thread forward to a comfortable resting stop located just a short distance behind our hook eye, where we'll now press firmly forward together both the black and orange body strips, binding them both firmly in position along the hook shank's top with a few more carefully wound, well-placed, snug-drawn thread wraps. With our segmented body well formed, we're now ready to install our forward set of medium round rubber legs using the same smooth, convenient pinch guide position, thread and bobbin method exercised earlier when tying in our legs at rear. With both the near side and far side front legs now snugly positioned along the body's center line, we'll next take a moment to prepare ourselves an indicator dot by trimming a short 1/4 to 3/8 inch long tab from our pre-cut yellow foam strips, and with the yellow tab placed neatly atop our black foam's front and squarely above where we just lashed our legs, we'll then go ahead and bind in our yellow indicator dot with a few well-placed tight wound thread wraps made directly over top one another like shown. With our body, legs, and indicator post all settled, we'll next pull rearward both the black and orange foam strips, helping expose our shank, and we'll build quickly in front of them towards our hook eye a nice, neat, thick wound thread base. Once built, we'll next go ahead and carefully install underneath our black and orange body strips and just behind our hook eye a nice, neat whip finish. Naturally, once snugly whipped, we're now free to carefully trim away, closely at the whip knot's base, our excess tying thread. And with the excess thread cleanly removed, we can now give our ant a nice, neat, block-shaped head by trimming back squarely just a short distance in front of our hook eye, both the black and orange foam strips together with a single, crisp, smooth, straight-line cut of our scissors. We'll now take a moment if necessary to trim our legs back equally and evenly to our desired fishing length, both far side and near. And once evenly snipped, and after a final, fast realignment of our body, perhaps if need be too, we're at last ready to end the fly with a heavy dab of high quality head cement or a liberal bead of fast drying Zap-A-Gap, jug neatly and evenly along the exposed underbody and belly side thread wrap's entirety. Well friends, there we have it. The Chernobyl Ant tight start to finish. This simple, high floating, all foam favorite has proven equally irresistible to trout, bass, panfish, and more on both western and eastern cold water and warm water fisheries alike. An especially wise choice in the summertime and fall, when all of the aforementioned game fish can be found eagerly slurping hoppers, beetles, crickets, and other such meaty morsels from the surface with reckless abandon, I so hope you'll give tying and fishing this fast food version of the wildly deadly Chernobyl ant a try. Hey gang, thanks again for tuning in today. Do have a look at our other Stone River Outfitters YouTube tutorials when you've some time. Do please remember to visit us on the web for all your fly fishing and fly tying needs, and as always, tight wraps and tight lines to all.